You're watching SBS PopAsia. I'm Andy Trieu, hanging out with international dance choreographer, it's Parris Goebel.
Hi.
So you've worked with so many Western and K-pop artists. Mm-hmm. Who would you say has been your favorite?
Probably Rihanna's probably my favorite.
Rihanna?
And J-Lo. Oh, wow. So. In K-pop, probably, oh, it's tough. I really enjoyed working with CL. She's pretty cool. We clicked a lot, and also, of course, BIGBANG.
What is your process like when you go into the room and meet an artist? Is it just straight down to business, or is there a bit of hangout time?
You know what? All of them are so different, but most of the time it's usually at a rehearsal. It's the first time I meet them, so we're kind of already, we just kind of say hi and get to work. But I've been pretty blessed to actually spend quite a lot of time with each artist to really, you know, gain a relationship with them and get to know them more personally. So
bang, bang, bang.
You've done songs like BIGBANG, Bang Bang Bang, which mm-hmm. is like super iconic. How does one come up with choreography like that?
I just feel the music and I just create. Like, it's really, it's quite natural and simple for me. I don't overthink it. I just like to feel it and see what comes naturally, really. Yeah.
Okay. You were in BIGBANG's Bang Bang Bang. Mm-hmm. What was it like to be in that music video?
It was kind of crazy because I had to choreograph it and be in at the same time, so as soon as we finished doing the scenes, then I had to get ready and get changed. But that shoot especially was really crazy. Like, the hours were madness. We were shooting like all through the night to the next day, and then we had power naps, and yeah, it was pretty crazy.
You've also worked with many girl groups as well, like 4 Minute, and also boy groups like mm-hmm. BIGBANG. What would you say is like the main differences?
The boys are usually pretty more chill, more quiet, and the girls, like, I find, like, they ask a lot of questions. They want to, like, know more about, like, how to do this and how to do that.
So that compared to Hello Biscuits. Hello Biscuits, what was that shoot like?
That was different because it was quicker. Like, we only had, like, a short time, like, one day to shoot. And because it was a one-shot kind of vibe, if we had missed a section, then we would have screwed, like, the whole video, so we couldn't miss any sections.
You were choreographing things for Icon. When they're shooting their music video, are you generally there as well, trying to fix up anything?
I have been like overseas and I send like footage of it, of choreography. So sometimes it hasn't been hands-on with them, but training-wise it was hands-on. But yeah, for the choreography, I'm usually not there for the music video.
And can you tell us a bit about your experience coming up with Taeyong Ringling?
He saw a video I did with some of my friends in LA, and it was just like all these like LA boys, and I called it like I Love Cali Boys. And I guess he saw it and he was like, okay, I want that exact thing, but for me. So we kind of just did the exact same feel, but different moves to obviously his single. He flew to LA and we kind of just learnt it on the spot and then like filmed it the next day. It was very, very quick. And then after that, that's when I got to work with BIGBANG. So a lot of doors opened from that one.
What are your thoughts of the future of dance? What do you think will go viral?
So I feel like, honestly, people are getting a little bit more like easily impressed. Like, I just feel like a lot of people are just, they like kind of anything dance. I hope like that the public can kind of see like the more quality dance, and I hope that becomes more viral.
What do you think are some of the differences between working in K-pop and working with Western artists?
I just feel like K-pop has a lot more money to invest in their projects. The sets are a little bit bigger and fancier. You have more time to rehearse, more time on set. So just probably the budget is just, it plays a big part, I think, in the production. They're the top standard, I think, for music videos, really.
If anyone wants to be a dance choreographer like you, what tips would you give them?
The most important thing is just to stay true to yourself, and how you naturally move is the most important thing. Like, trying to include how you feel and how you move, and not trying to copy in anyone else. As long as you're staying true to your style, I think there's a uniqueness and beauty in that. And once people see that, then people will gravitate towards you. That's the most important thing I would say. As long as you're doing your own thing, I think that you're already on the right path.
Parris, thank you so much for hanging out.